मेरा हुसैन बागे रिसालत का फूल है, मेरा हुसैन बागे रिसालत का फूल है। तुसी भी मिलकर कह दो मैं।
हजरत इमाम आली मकाम स्टॉप्ड एट अ प्लेस नियर नीनवा व्हिच इज जस्ट आउटसाइड ऑफ कूफा। When they stopped there, Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam asked his rufaqa and friends, tell me, where have we stopped? Why have we come here? Why is it that we've stopped here? And they said, oh Imam, this place is called Karbala. Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam said, we can't move from this place now. This is the place where I am to be martyred. Balke, this is not Karbala. This is Karbu wa Bala'un, Karbo Bala. When you split the word Karbala into two, it spells two words, Karbun Bala'un. Karb means regret and sorrow and sadness. Bala'un means musibat and mushkil. This land is the land of sadness. This land is the land of difficulty. They said to the Rufaqa, pitch your tents here. We will not move from here to go to Kufa. When Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam radiallahu ta'ala anhu was standing in Karbala, one of the men asked, oh Hussein, where are you from? Hazrat Imam Hussein said, we used to live in a place called Medina Munawwara. But now we are the residents of Karbala. This is where we will stay. This is the place that we will pitch camp. Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam at that moment had 73 people with them. 73 people on Karbala. Yazid's army numbered 22,000 on that day. Hazrat Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhu didn't come to fight. They had no political motive or objective.
Hazrat, if Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam was greedy or thirsty, and these words, no doubt, are not worthy for Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam. To make you understand, if Imam Hussein had any inclination towards leadership, he would never have left Makkah Mukarramah with his children. If he was going out to do battle and have a war, Hazrat, he would have taken an army with him. Dr. Zakir Naik, very clearly in one of his talks, said that Imam Hussein had political objectives when he went to Karbala. Imam Hussein had no political objective when he went to Karbala. Imam Hussein didn't go for the kursi, he wasn't fighting for the leadership.
Imam Hussein radiallahu ta'ala anhu is going to leave an example for mankind that in the face of injustice and oppression, in the face of wrongdoing, if you have to take your family and stand up against it, then you must do that. Imam Hussein is leaving an example for people here that he's brought his six-month-old son Ali Asghar with him. He's brought his eldest son, the great Ali Akbar Shabihur Rasul, the one who looked like the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. He brought Imam Qasim, the son of Imam Hassan Mujtaba radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Hazrat Imam Ali Baqam bought Hazrat Abdullah bin Jafar at Tayyar's sons, Abdullah, Hazrat Imam Muhammad and Aun. Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam radiallahu ta'ala anhu bought their daughter Sayyida Sakina and their sister Sayyida Zainab. Imam Hussein didn't come to fight. Imam Hussein was going to Kufa to see the people. But he didn't tell the people the real reason why he's going. The real reason was that he was to defend his grandfather's deen. He was standing up against zulm. What is kalimatul haq? Kalimatul haq, raising the truth, is when you stand up against a sultan jair, you stand up against a zalim sultan, an unjust, oppressive ruler. Standing up against him is the greatest jihad that anyone can do. And yakinan Imam Hussein did the greatest jihad. He stood up against an illegitimate leader. In the name of Yazid, He stood up against a drunkard. He stood up against somebody who made halal haram and haram halal. Imam Ali Maqam was not wrong. Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam was right. But why did he take everyone with him? To leave an example to tell people. If you want to see sacrifice, then look no further. The ones who sacrificed the most and were tested the most were none other than the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam's family members. The Ahlul Bayt were tested the most. They were tested in every way. In Karbala, we've seen that, and we will now see that. When Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam bought their family, Hazrat Imam Hussein radiallahu ta'ala pitched camp in Karbala. It was the 2nd of Muharram. During this time, the leader of Yazid's army was a man called Amr bin Saad. Amr bin Saad was appointed by Yazid to become the governor of Tehran, which was in Arabic called Ray. The governor of Ray, which is modern day Tehran in Iran. Tehran is the capital of Iran, if I'm not mistaken. And he, Amr bin Saad ibn Abi Waqqas. Amr bin Saad ibn Abi Waqqas. Amr was the son of Saad bin Abi Waqqas. Do you know who was Saad was? He was that Sahabi that Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam would give them an arrow in Uhud and said, O Saad, may my mother and father be qurban for you. May my mother and father be sacrificed for you. The greatest archer amongst the Sahaba was Hazrat Saad. They said in one go, in one moment, one flow, he could fire out 100 arrows at one time. So such accuracy and the greatness of his archery. Hazrat Saad bin Waqqas, Ibn Abi Waqqas was a great Jalilul Qadr Sahabi. He was from the Ashra-i Mubashara, the 10 who were promised paradise in this dunya by the Prophet ﷺ. He had a son called Amr, or Amir bin Saad. Amr bin Saad, this individual was who? He was given the governorship of Tehran, Iran, of modern day Iran. He was on his way to be the governor when Yazid sent a letter to him to say, before you go to Rai, go to Karbala and fight against Imam Hussein. When he received this letter, he was going from Kufa and he was called back by Ibn Ziyad. He said, look, I don't want to fight the grandson of the Prophet. I don't want to be held responsible for the murder of Imam Hussein. I don't want to do this. Ibn Ziyad said, if that's the case, you give back what Yazid has given you and go. You don't need to fight. He said, look, I can't give back what he's given me. Give me one night to think about this. Amr bin Saad went back to his tent, went back to his resting place. And that night he began to think. One minute, he's looking at the order, this paper that he's been given by Yazid that you are now the governor, and saying, I can't leave the governorship. Then his mind changes and said, I can't kill the Prophet's grandson. He's Hussein. Then he changed his mind and said, no, I can't leave this. Then he changed his mind and said, no, I can't kill the grandson. His nephew came to see him that night. His nephew came to him, and Hamza ibn Mughira is the name of his nephew. He said, I want to tell you something. Leave the governorship of Rai. This is nothing. Leave it, but do not kill the grandson of the Prophet. Do not kill the grandson of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Do not take the responsibility of this murder. Don't stain your hands and your neck with the blood of Imam Hussein. That night, Amr bin Saad, he couldn't sleep. He was thinking again. In the morning, he decided. He went to Ubaidullah ibn Ziyad and he said, Ibn Ziyad, forgive me. Ibn Ziyad, forgive me. Ibn Ziyad said, give me the papers back. He said, I can't leave the governorship. I want to be the governor. Therefore, I will go and fight Hussein. Hazrat, what lesson do you learn from this? Would you go after the dunya and compromise your iman? His iman was in question here. He was put in a situation. He chose money. He chose power. He chose control, leadership over doing the right thing. His mind was polluted with the love of this dunya. And he said to Ibn Ziyad, look, I'll do anything, but I can't leave being the governor. I want to be the governor. When he said this, Amr bin Saad, we have to bear in mind, he made this decision. A point to ponder and contemplate over. Amr is the son of Sa'ad bin Abi Waqqas. Are you going to say that Hazrat Sa'ad is bad because of the decision of his son? You can't. If people are there saying, Amr bin Sa'ad, Amr, he's bad. Sa'ad is bad because of Amr. Then we have to bear in mind that Hazrat Nuh alayhi salam was a Nabi of Allah Ta'ala. But his an Rasul, Ulul Azam min al-Rasul, his son was a kafir. Are you going to say Hazrat Nuh is wrong because his son was a kafir? You can't say that. Likewise, you know Shimr, Lain, the one who chopped Imam Hussein's head off. He was the brother-in-law of Hazrat Ali. He was Hazrat Ali's brother-in-law. Are you going to say Hazrat Ali is wrong because his brother-in-law is Shimr? They are not accountable for the mistakes of those that came after them. They will not be held responsible. Hazrat Amr bin Sa'ad is not wrong. This is a lie if you hear outside. Sa'ad bin Abi Waqqas was wrong. Amr was wrong. But Sa'ad bin Abi Waqqas radiallahu ta'ala wasn't wrong. So we've got to keep this point in mind. When Amr bin Sa'ad went and he wanted to have a meeting with Imam Hussein. The situation arose that he wanted a meeting with Hazrat Imam Hussein. They sat down and they met. Hazrat Imam Hussein and Amr bin Sa'ad were related. Their khandans were related. Going back into the lineage, they had relations. When Amr bin Sa'ad took a group of people, he said, you come with me, we're going to see Hussein. You know what those people that he chose said? He said, how can we go to him? How can we show our face to Imam Hussein? We called him here and now we're standing against him. How can we show our face to him? These were those people, these extreme lovers of Hazrat Ali. The word Shia, is used in the Quran as well. The word Shia means extreme lover. These were people that were known as Shi'ane Ali, hardcore lovers of Hazrat Ali. There were factions within these groups, within the Shia, who believed Hazrat Ali Ma'azallah was God. They believed Hazrat Ali should have been a Nabi. The hardcore Shia, the hardcore Rafizis, the worst of the type, who sit and curse Sayyidina Abu Bakr and Umar. They hold gatherings swearing at the Khulafai Rashidin, Hazrat Abu Bakr and Umar and Uthman. Sayyidina Aisha, they curse and swear. These were people who called Sayyidina Ali. And when it came to it, called Hazrat Imam Hussein. And the same people turned their back against him as well. Allahu Akbar. Nafi bin Hilal came to Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam and said, O Imam, go home please. He met Rasulullah's grandson and said, go home please. They've killed Muslim. They are uncased and the children. They've come to fight you and kill you. They will not let you live. These people are going to butcher and murder you alive. They will not spare you or your family. Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam's was listening to this and he continued to say, try to go home, please. Because you mean everything to the people. Deep down, everyone knows that you are the great Imam. They know that you are the most worthy for this. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam's grandson, Hazrat Imam Hussein, smiled at him. I said, if Allah Ta'ala has ordained something, if Allah Ta'ala has written something like this to happen, if this, then how can it be changed? Yani, this was Qaza-e Mubram, that destiny which is unchangeable. Qaza-e Mubram, the destiny which is unchangeable destiny, is preordained. I was meant to be here. I am meant to be here. How can it be changed? I can't go back. Then they had a meeting. Amr and his representatives and Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam. Hazrat Imam Hussein was offered three options. Either accept Yazid or be prepared to die. Hazrat Imam Hussein said, I'll give you three options. Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam said, number one, let me go home. My people are asking, so for them I am asking you. They want me to go, I'm asking. Let me go home for my people. Number two, if not, let me go somewhere else to preach Islam. Number three, if these two are not accepted, then take me to Yazid and I will speak to him directly. Amr bin Saad became very happy. Amr bin Saad said, these three conditions are very good. One of them will be accepted. I'll go back to Ibn Ziyad. Ibn Ziyad is going to accept. When Ibn Ziyad received this from Amr bin Saad, Ibn Ziyad began to discuss. Sat next to Ibn Ziyad was Shimr al-Ain. Shimr was sat. Shimr goes, Ibn Ziyad, what are you doing? Are you here to bargain with Hussein? Have you come to bargain with the Imam? Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam radiallahu ta'ala anhu, don't accept any of these conditions. Don't accept any of these conditions. This is all the plan of Amr bin Saad. He does not want to be, he doesn't want to sit here, he wants to be in right. He's trying to wriggle out of this. No, don't accept this. When this was done and said, Shimr said, Ibn Ziyad, let me take over the army. I will be in charge. I will control all matters and affairs. There and then, he said, let me be the governor of Tehran and write a letter to him and tell him Hussein, tell him to kill Hussein or to give up this governorship. Yani, Shimr is saying to Ibn Ziyad, write to or tell Amr bin Saad, kill Hussein or give the governorship back. When Amr bin Saad heard this and spoke, he said, look, I didn't send you to reconcile with Imam Hussein radiallahu ta'ala anhu. I didn't reconcile with him or to do bayah with me and Yazid, if not, kill him. Tell him to do bayah with Ibn Ziyad, otherwise he's going to be killed. Amr said to Shimr, Amr was there, he said, Shimr, you know this, all of this is your fault. You are the one who is causing these problems. You want to fight the Ahlul Bayt. When he said this, I will not give up the governorship of Rai. Fine, I will go out and fight against Imam Hussein radiallahu ta'ala. Then, under the command and hukam of Amr bin Saad, we arrived at the 7th of Muharram and Amr bin Saad ordered that the water be stopped. He ordered 4,000 horsemen to go and stand at the Euphrates River, Nahr-e Furat, 4,000, and said, do not give water and let the Ahlul Bayt drink water from here. For 3 days and three nights, water was stopped. Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Imam Hussein said that, look, you are 22,000 people. We are 73 in number. If you are stopping water from us, fine. But what have the women done to you? What have our children done to you? Why are you stopping water from them? Even animals drink from that water. Non-Muslims are allowed to drink from that water, but you don't let us drink from the water. These people forgot that the Malik of Kawthar, the one who owns the pool and the fountain on the day of Qiyamah, Abi Kawthar. Nabi alayhi salat, inna a'tainaka al-Kawthar, indeed we gave you al-Kawthar. Ibn Abbas said, Kawthar here means the river from paradise, which is promised and given to the Prophet ﷺ, and that his ummah will drink from this water. He said, Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam is Malik al-Kawthar, my father is Saki al-Kawthar. My father is the one who's going to distribute this water. Nabi alayhi salam said, this water is whiter than milk, sweeter than honey. Whoever drinks this water will never feel thirst ever again. He will never be thirsty. They will enter paradise with no thirst. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said, there will be vessels that will be like stars that they will be given in. If you want water from this, then remember Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman and Ali will be distributing this water. That's why Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam said that I am the Malik of Kawthar and my grandfather is the Malik of Kawthar and my father is the Saki, the supplier, the distributor of that water. Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam radiyallahu ta'ala anhu said and plead to them that let the children drink. They said nobody is allowed to drink this water. The 9th of Muharram arrived. I'm going to stop here for 2 minutes. On the 7th of Muharram al-Haram, the water was stopped from the Ahlul Bayt. By the 9th of Muharram, Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam came out of the Khaymah, the tent. And Imam Hussein radiallahu ta'ala anhu delivered a sermon. All the people were standing in front of them. And they said all praises to Allah Ta'ala. And they sent salawat upon the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Nabi alayhi salatu was salam's grandson, Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam radiyallahu ta'ala anhu said, people, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever leaves the sunnah and adopts bid'ah, he makes halal haram and haram halal. He oppresses the people and he rules over them with oppression. He who doesn't oppose that person, that leader, then he will be in the fire of Jahannam with those oppressors. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam's grandson Imam Ali Maqam said, Yazid has disobeyed Allah and his Rasul. I am the one who is the protector of Islam. And I am the one who is the grandson of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I am the one about whom Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said that Hassan and Hussein are the leaders of paradise. And Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, grandson radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, they were there to defend Islam. After delivering the khutbah, the sermon, Yazid's army began to prepare for a fight. They did not take heed to what Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam said to them. They were prepared to fight. Hazrat Imam Hussein sent a few people to the Yazidis and said, give me one more night. And he gave me the 10th night of Muharram. That night was a Friday night. Nabi alayhi salatu salam's grandson, Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam, after Salatul Isha, got all of the family together and said, oh my family, I am very happy with you. Oh my friends, I am very happy with you. You can go home if you want. This is not your war. This is not your battle. Go home. Take your children. These people want my blood. They want me. They don't want nobody else. When Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam said this, all of them turned around and said, "O Imam, we are with you. What answer are we going to give to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam on the day of Qiyamah? If the Prophet asked us, that my grandson stood on Karbala, where were you? How can we say that we left you here and we went home to save our own lives? This can't happen. We are ready to fight alongside you and defend you and Islam." Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam became very happy. They made dua for their people. And they said, "Oh my people, be patient. Be patient. Go tonight, read your tahajjud. And remember Allah tonight. Do zikr and azkar. Do ibadat. And in the morning we shall see." When all the family went and spent their nights in the tent, this last night on Karbala, Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam's grandson, Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam, they read the tahajjud and they went to sleep. In their sleep, Hazrat Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam came. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam came and they hugged Hazrat Imam Hussein. They kissed Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam and they made a dua. They said, "Allahumma a'til Husayna sabran wa ajra. Oh Allah, grant my grandson Hussein patience, sabr, and give him great ajr for this." Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam woke up in the morning and they performed Salatul Fajr. Hazrat, on Karbala, there were two jamaats that were happening. Yazid were doing their own jamaat and Imam Ali Maqam was doing their own jamaat. Imam Hussein's azan was there, their azan was there. Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam radiyallahu ta'ala anhu read Fajr Salah, and remember, for 3 days and three nights there was no water. They were doing tayammum. When there's no water, then you use soil and dust to perform wudu. They were doing tayammum and they read the Salatul Fajr. Hazrat Baba Farid Shakar Ganj rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi, Hazrat Baba Farid rahmatullah alayhi, he narrates a waqia that there was a man who seen a dream, and inside this dream he seen a woman covered sweeping the land of Karbala, and the women asked, "Who are you? What are you cleaning? What place is this that you are clean?" The woman replied and said, "I am Fatima to Zahra bint Rasulullah. I am Fatima, the daughter of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And I am cleaning the place where my son is going to be killed. This place is called Karbala." Hazrat Muhtaram, Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam led the Fajr Jamaat. It was the 10th of Muharram and they made dua. The 10th of Muharram arrived and Amr bin Saad's cronies, his soldiers, they drew first blood and fired the first arrow. They began to fire arrows at the tents of Imam Ali Maqam. Remember, Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam's granddaughter Sayyida Zainab was here. The great-granddaughter Sayyida Sakina was here. Hazrat Imam Hussein's two wives were here. Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam's friends, their true lovers, stood up and said, "Huzur, Ya Imam, let us go out and fight against these enemies." Let us go out and fight against these enemies. When Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam radiallahu ta'ala anhu did this and said this, Hazrat Imam Hussein gave ijazat, and those close friends and rufaqa that were there, they went out and fought with great valor, with great courage, and they tasted the sweetness of martyrdom. Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam seen what was happening, and they came out on their horse, and they stood in front of Yazid's army, and they said, "Do you know who I am? I am the grandson of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What are these people doing here?" And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi grandson seen all those who invited them. "Who is so and so? Who is so and so? Who is so and so?" Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi grandson, Hazrat Imam Hussein radiallahu ta'ala anhu, see who? Hur bin Yazid. Who's Hur? Hur is the person who brought Imam Ali Maqam to Karbala. He said, "I didn't know what happened. I didn't know the full story, the full extent." So Hur bin Yazid said, "I can't let you go alone. I have to escort you. I won't take you as a captive. I'll take you there and I'll leave you and I'll go and join the army." Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam radiallahu ta'ala anhu, when they seen Hur bin Yazid there, Imam Ali Maqam said, "Hur, what are you doing there? Hur, you are not from these people." Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam said, "Who's going to help me? Who is going to fight with me?" Hur bin Yazid was thinking, "Jahannam is pulling me one way. Jannat is calling me the other way. How can I stay there?" Hazrat Hur bin Yazid radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he marched out of his army and came and stood alongside Imam Ali Maqam, and Hazrat Hur began to fight. Hazrat Hur said, "We are the ones who stopped water from Imam Ali Maqam. Yet this is the same Imam Ali Maqam whose grandfather will give and is the Malik of Kausar. He owns this water that Allah has given. He has ownership over Abi Kausar. He will give water to whoever he wills. How is it that I can stand on the side of the enemy and I can't stand on the side of the leader of paradise?" Hazrat Hur set out and began to fight. One by one, Hazrat Hur bin Yazid began to fight them, killing them. And eventually, it became too much and he tasted the sweetness of martyrdom. Hazrat, the battle was in full flow now. Imam Ali Maqam's friends were being martyred there and then in front of them. Then Hazrat Zainab radiallahu ta'ala anha's two sons were standing. Hazrat Muhammad and Hazrat Aun. They were 13, 14 year olds. They went to their grandfather and they said, they went to their uncle, Hazrat Imam Hussein, and said that, "Oh uncle, give us ijazat to fight." Hazrat Zainab radiallahu ta'ala anha, when she heard, Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam said, "You are young." Sayyidah Zainab said, "Oh my brother, on the day of Qiyamah, what answer will I give? That my sons were there and my sons didn't step out to fight. Oh my brother, I sacrificed my sons for this cause." Allahu Akbar, Hazrat Muhammad and Aun, Imam Ali Maqam put the armor on him. Their swords were with them and they went out to fight. Hazrat Muhammad and Aun said, "Oh people, do you know who we are? We are the nephews of Imam Hussein. We are the grandsons of Ali al-Murtaza. And Hazrat Abdullah ibn Abi Ja'far al-Tayyar, we are the sons of Hazrat Abdullah ibn Ja'far and the grandsons of Hazrat Ja'far radiyallahu ta'ala an. O enemies of Islam, come kill us. quench your thirst by killing us. When Hazrat Muhammad and Aun, who were young, fighting in the way of Allah, this great jihad that they were doing, this great struggle against an oppressive ruler and leadership and rulership, they tasted the sweetness of martyrdom. Nabi alayhi salatu salam's grandson Imam Hussein said, "Oh Zainab, your sons have been martyred as well. They have been killed and they are in Jannatul Firdaus as well." Hazrat Imam Hussein radiallahu ta'ala anhu, seeing that the women were crying, imagine seeing your children being killed in front of you. What crime have they done? What did the women do? What did the children do? What did Hazrat Imam Hussein do? "Oh Zainab, your sons are in paradise." And Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam said to the women, "Oh women, have sabr. Go back to your tents and have sabr." And then Hazrat Zainab came and said, "Oh grandson of Rasulullah, brother, your son Ali Askar is 6 months. Ali Askar is 6 months old. He's crying. He needs water. 3 days and three nights, no water has come to him. Go and ask them to give water." Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam took Hazrat Ali Asghar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. At this moment in time, Hazrat Ali Asghar, 6 months old, with Imam Hussein, crying and said, "How shall we quench the thirst of this boy? They've blocked the river of Furat. The Euphrates River, they've blocked it. We have no access to this water." Allahu Akbar, the son of Ali al-Murtaza stood. His name is Abbas al-Amdar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Hazrat Abbas was the stepbrother of Imam Hussein. Hazrat Abbas came out in passion and said, "Oh my brother, I will bring water for your son. Hold on, I will bring water for your son." Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam radiallahu ta'ala anhu's brother Abbas al-Amdar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he was leaving the tent and Sayyida Sakina came running, 6 years old. Sayyida Sakina came running and crying, saying, "Uncle, uncle, I need water as well." Hazrat Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu took the mashkiza, the water sack, and they went towards the river. 4,000 men seen Hazrat Abbas. Hazrat Abbas was one lion on his own. 4,000 were standing there. Allahu Akbar, Hazrat Abbas began to fight them. Arrows were being fired at Hazrat Abbas. Hazrat Abbas said, "Are you people Muslims or kafir?" They replied, "We are Muslims." He said, "What kind of Islam do you have? You have stopped water from the Prophet's family. What iman do you people have? Can't you see the children are crying? What kind of Muslims are you?" Allahu Akbar. When Hazrat Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu, when they said this, Hazrat Abbas began to fight. Fighting broke through the ranks. Hazrat Abbas got the water from the river. He went through the 4,000. He had to go back now. Hazrat Abbas is wounded. And they began to pound onto the horse of Hazrat Abbas. They killed the horse. And Hazrat Abbas stood there alone. He stood there fighting. Over his shoulder in one hand, he had the water casket. In the other hand, he had a sword. Hazrat Abbas's bazu, they were cut on this day. Fighting with one arm was cut. He took the water and put it over his neck, took the sword with the other hand, and began to fight, and his other arm was cut. Then they begin to hound upon him, and one by one they are slaying Hazrat Abbas al-Amdar. Hazrat Abbas can hear the children cry. He's telling them, "I will be with you. I've gone to get the water for you." There and then Hazrat Abbas tasted the sweetness of martyrdom. Allahu Akbar. Those people, they began to say, "We won't let you have the water. As the leader has said," he replied, Hazrat Abbas, before martyrdom, he said, You don't think about the Prophet alayhi salat wa salam's family. When he began to get this water and put the vessel in their mouth, Allahu Akbar. Hazrat Abbas martyred there and then before Imam Ali Maqam's eyes. One by one, afraad of the Ahlul Bayt were being martyred. There was very few left. There was one who was known as Shabihur Rasul. He looked like the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Everyone in the family knew that Imam Hussein's eldest son, Ali Akbar, he resembled Rasulullah from head to toe. He was 18 years old, 19 years old. Hazrat Ali Akbar radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, "My father, give me permission to go and fight now. Let me go and fight these people who are fighting against you." Hazrat Ali Akbar was given permission and he began to chant a slogan. He said, "Ana Ali ibn Hussein ibn Ali, nahnu awladun Nabi." He said, "I am Ali, the son of Hussein, the son of Ali. We are the children of the Prophet. We are the children of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam." When Hazrat Ali Akbar radiallahu ta'ala anhu stood in front of the enemies, he said, "O killers of the Prophet's family, do you know who I am? My grandfather's Ali al-Murtaza. My father is Hussein, the leader of paradise. My great-grandfather is Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Do you know who I am? My grandmother is Fatima al-Zahra. Do you know who I am? I am the one in whose house Hazrat Jibreel used to come to. Do you know who I am? The Quran was revealed in our house. You want to fight me? Come and fight me. Quench your blood. Quench your thirst with my blood." Allahu Akbar. Hazrat Ali Askar Akbar radiallahu ta'ala anhu so violently spoke, nobody would come forward. There was a man called Tariq bin Shi standing there. Tariq bin Shi came forward and said, "If I kill this boy, what will I get in return?" And he said, "I'm going to Amr." Amr bin Saad said, "You know what we'll give you? You'll become the governor of Mosul." Amr bin Saad said this. At the same time, he said, "You know who you're going to kill now? You're going to kill the son of Hussein. Remember this. How great are they? You know their maqam." Tariq came forward and began to fight Ali Akbar. Hazrat Ali Akbar was fighting Tariq bin Shis. And Tariq bin Shis was killed by Ali Akbar's sword. Tariq had four sons, Umar and Talha. They came forward and Hazrat Ali Akbar killed them as well. Hazrat Imam Ali Akbar radiallahu ta'ala anhu came back to Hazrat Imam Hussein. Hazrat Imam Hussein asked, "My son, what's happened to you?" He said, "My father, al-atash, I am thirsty. My father, I am so thirsty that yakinan, if I had one drop of water, I have such blood inside me. I have the blood of Ali in me. I need one drop of water, one sip, and I will annihilate this entire army, or my father, on my own." Hazrat Imam Hussein looked at him and cried. And he said, "Oh my son, where can I get water for you today?" And then Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam kissed their son. They cleaned the blood from them. "Quench your thirst with my saliva." Hazrat Ali Akbar went back onto the battlefield. Hazrat Ali Akbar took so much strength from Hazrat Imam Hussein. He said, "Who from you wants the governorship of Mosul? Come forward and fight me now. Fight me for this governorship." No one came forward to fight Ali Akbar. This man, Shimr Ziljoshan, he said, "This young boy has killed a few and all of you are scared. Go and attack him. One by one, attack him." Hazrat Ali Akbar was 19 years old. arrows were being fired at him. My brothers, look at today's 19-year-olds. And look at the 19-year-olds of the Ahlul Bayt. Look at their maqam and what they were doing. What have we done for our deen and religion? What have we done? Tell me. Look what Hazrat Ali Akbar did. He sacrificed his life for the Prophet's religion. To defend his father and the honor of his grandfather, radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. Wa sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Hazrat Imam Hussein radiyallahu ta'ala anhu seen Ali Akbar fighting. But again, there were 22,000 in number. It was too much. There was not enough water. Hazrat Ali Akbar was martyred and tasted the sweetness of martyrdom on the plains of Karbala. Hazrat Imam Hussein came out. Can you imagine how they were feeling? Taking the blessed son's head. Ali Akbar's head was severed. And they took their head behind and back. And they said, at that time when Hazrat Ali Akbar was, before his martyrdom, Hazrat Ali Akbar was with Imam Hussein. He said, I have one dream, O my father, one dream. That dream is that when my sword, when my neck leaves my body, your face is in front of me. I want to see you before I die. Hazrat Imam Hussein took the body of Hazrat Ali Akbar and put it into the tent. He put it into the tent on one side and said, O Allah, today I have fulfilled the sunnah of Ibrahim. Ibrahim alayhi salam was asked to slaughter his son. Ya Allah, you stopped that. I have gone one step forward. I have actually given my son in your way. I have sacrificed my son in your way. Ya Allah, Ibrahim alayhi salam was blindfolded. When he was asked, I had my eyes open and I seen my son die in front of me. Allah, accept this sacrifice of mine. Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam made this dua. Sayyidah Zainab was crying. And she began to say, my brother's son has been killed as well now. My brother's son has been sacrificed in the way of Allah. The women came and said, O Imam, O our leader, take Ali Asghar. Take Hazrat Ali Asghar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Maybe they will have some remorse in their hearts. He's 6 months old. Surely they can't kill him. They should have, and they will have they must have mercy on children. Hazrat Imam Hussein said, these people have black hearts. They have no iman inside them. They're going to kill him. But for you, I will still do it. Hazrat Imam Hussein took their 6 month baby child, Hazrat Ali Asghar, in their hands, and they took it forward. They stood before the people of Karbala, the enemies on Karbala. And they said, you people want to kill me. Let my son drink some water. He's dying. The kuffar have mercy on children. Why can't you have mercy on children? Even non-Muslims will give Muslim children water. Why can't you give him water? Allahu Akbar, your problem is with me, not with my son. There was this Jahannami sitting there, standing there. His name was Hirmala. Hirmala seen Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam put their son in front. He took an arrow and he fired it at Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam's son Ali Askar. Brothers, this arrow pierced through the neck of Hazrat Ali Askar radiallahu anhu. In Imam Hussein's hands, blood was pouring through. You know, when we say the Ahlul Bayt are tested the most, this is what we mean. In the history of man, who has seen this much test? This much test. Your eldest son, your pride, martyred in front of you, killed in front of you. Your youngest son, what has he done wrong? He's 6 months, he's innocent, masoom. Killed in your hands. Blood is pouring from the neck of Hazrat Ali Askar. When he killed him, Imam Hussein radiallahu ta'ala anhu began to cry. Hazrat Imam Hussein took this blood of his son and they wiped the blood on their face. And when they wiped it on their beard, they said, oh Allah, I make this proof and witness and dalil on the day of judgment that they killed your prophet's children. These people killed your prophet's children in Karbala. I may make you witness to this atrocity. I make you witness to this oppression. Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam radiallahu ta'ala anhu, when the women seen Hazrat Ali Asghar's body, they began to cry. They began to cry and say, Karbala, Karbala, tell us, Karbala, what have we done wrong? Karbala, what have we done wrong today? That our children are being killed in front of us. What have we done wrong today? That the people around us, our loved ones are leaving. What has happened? How did Asghar fall asleep here? How did Ali Asghar find his sleep on Karbala? Allahu Akbar. Hazrat Imam Hussein said, oh women, my son's thirst has been quenched. They've killed him. Allahu Akbar. Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam had one more son on Karbala. His name is Ali Awsat, the middle Ali. Ali Akbar means the big Ali. Ali Asghar means the little Ali. Ali Awsat means the middle Ali. Hazrat Ali Awsat's laqab, his title, an honorary title he was known as Zainul Abideen. Hazrat Imam Zainul Abideen. Hazrat Imam Zainul Abideen was ill on the day of Karbala. He was severely ill. He couldn't move. Difficult. Hazrat Imam Zainul Abideen was adored by Imam Ali Maqam. Imam Hussein loved Hazrat Imam Zainul Abideen. Hazrat Zainul Abideen stood up with difficulty and went to his father. Look at the bravery and the courage of the Ahlul Bayt. He is ill and he said, oh my father, let me die in this way. Let me die fighting for the truth. Let me die. Imam Hussein asked him and said, oh my son, if I let you go and fight now, who's going to carry my family on? Who's going to carry my lari, my lineage on? How will the Sadat continue? Allahu Akbar. You have to accept all these difficulties, oh my son. You have to be brave and act in the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's way. Oh my son, I give you advice. Help the poor and help the women. And give my salam to my grandfather when you go back to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Imam Hussein is saying to his son that when you go back to Medina Sharif, tell my grandfather, Nana Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that Hussein was giving you salam. Can you imagine how Imam Ali Maqam was feeling? Telling his son that you can't fight today. You have to carry on my family today. You have to go back and give my salam to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Hazrat Ali Asghar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And say, oh my son, tell my grandfather. Tell your great grandfather, tell the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, that your grandson Hussein sacrificed everything on Karbala. The promise he made to you, he fulfilled that promise. He promised you that he was going to be patient and he was going to have sabr. He promised this. He fulfilled this promise. Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam took off the turban and they gave the dastare fazilat. They gave the turban to their son and said, you are my heir. You are the heir now. The Ahlul Bayt will continue from you. You will be the one who carries this one. Give Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam, their time had come now to stand on Karbala. Hazrat Imam Hussein gave salam to all the women and told them, said to them, oh women, have sabr. Do not complain to Allah Ta'ala. Have sabr and istiqlal. This is a test for you. Do not be ungrateful. Do not be of those people who do shikwa and shikayat to Allah Ta'ala. Hazrat Muhtaram, how must have the women felt at that time? When they've lost their sons in this battle. They've lost their brothers. They've lost their loved ones. The time had come now that Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam, Hazrat Imam Shabbir, Ali al-Murtaza radiallahu ta'ala anhu's son was to step forward. Hazrat Imam Hussein told them, have sabr, and the women had great sabr. Hazrat Imam Hussein radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, remember the sabr of Hazrat Ali al-Murtaza and Hazrat Fatima al-Zahra. Be firm, have istiqamat, don't cry. Allah Almighty is with those who are patient. Hazrat, these points that I'm making, these words of Imam Hussein are lessons that we learn. This is not just a mere story. This is a story that changed the course of Islamic history. These are lessons. When you're tested, what should you do? Have sabr. With sabr comes great ajr. Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam gave salam to all of them. Sayyida Zainab took the turban of Hazrat Ali al-Murtaza, the sword of Mullah Ali, the horse of Mullah Ali, and they got them prepared and ready. Sayyida Sakina was 7 years old. Sayyida Sakina's rishta was given to Hazrat Hassan Mujtaba's son Imam Qasim, who also died in Karbala. Imam Qasim was 13, 14 years old and he fought and was martyred. Sayyida Sakina said to Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam, my father, where are you going? Everyone has gone as well. Why are you leaving me now as well? Oh, my father, don't leave. Hazrat Imam Hussein radiallahu ta'ala an picked up Sayyida Sakina and kissed her. You know, we all have daughters. How hard is it? The love that we show to our daughters. Imagine how Imam Hussein felt leaving his daughter behind. Sayyida Zainab came over. And Sayyida Zainab said to Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam, and Imam Ali Maqam Ghaliban and most said to Hazrat Sayyida Zainab, the sister of Hazrat Imam Hussein, said, look after her and don't make her ever feel that her father has left her. Don't let her feel this pain. Hazrat Zainab radiallahu ta'ala anha said, oh my brother, today we have all become orphans on Karbala. We have all lost people we love on Karbala. Hussein said, Zainab, have sabr. Be patient. And remember, this is the will of Allah Ta'ala. This is the raza of Allah. Be pleased with the raza of Allah Ta'ala. Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam now is standing or walking towards that horse. Hazrat, before Imam Hussein would take each of them to the horse. But who is now left to take Imam Hussein to the horse? Hazrat Imam Hussein radiallahu ta'ala anha said one last goodbye, and Sayyida Zainab loved Imam Hussein so much. Imam Hussein's mother, Sayyida Fatima, passed away when he was 7-8 years old. Sayyida Zainab was like a mother to Imam Hussein. Sayyida Zainab used to look after Imam Hussein, brought up Imam Hussein. She was the elder sister. Hazrat, we will see the maqam of Sayyida Zainab when she stood before Yazid and Ibn Ziyad. Allahu Akbar. Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam radiallahu ta'ala anhu met Sayyida Zainab one last time. Imam Hussein rode on their horse and stood in front of them on Karbala. And Imam Ali Maqam began the khutbah. What a khutbah it was. All this narration and riwayat that I'm mentioning, this story, this waqi'ah, you'll find this in the tariq of Imam Tabari. You can buy the tariq of Imam Tabari in English for around 200 to 800 pounds. It's a huge collection of the history of Islam. You'll find all these waqi'ats mentioned in there. Tabari is an accepted historian of the Ahlus Sunnati wal Jama'ah. Likewise, Zahabi is one. Likewise, Ibn Kasir, these are historians. Ibn Asir's Kamil, Fit Tariq. These books mention this waqia. Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam stood and said, do you know who I am? I am Hussein Ibn Ali. I am Hussein, the son of Ali. He said, you know who I am? I am Hussein ibn Fatima. I am Hussein, the son of Fatima to Zahra. Do you know who my father is? He's the Fatih of Khaybar. He defeated Khaybar on his own. Do you know who I am? I am the son of the one about whom the Prophet said, Ali is from me and I am from Ali. Do you know who I am? I am the son of Fatima to Zahra, the leader of the women of paradise. Do you know who I am? Do you know who my grandfather is? My grandfather is Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Do you know my grandfather is he who Allah ta'ala sent the Quran to? Do you know my house is the house Jibreel used to come to? The archangel would come to my house. Do you know who I am? The Quran was revealed to us. The Quran was sent to us. Do you know who I am? We are those people that in namaz you say, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala Ali Sayyidina Muhammad. You send durood and salam upon us in salah. This is who I am. This is who we are. Hazrat Imam Ali Maqam said, you have no excuse left now. Come forward and kill me. Fight me now. Fight me like the men you think you are. Allahu Akbar. Amr bin Saad and Shimr Zil-Joshan said, kill him. Kill him. He's the one that we need to kill. He's the one who has revolted against the leadership. He's the one who's gone against Yazid. Hazrat Imam Hussein, Imam Ali Maqam, Allahu Akbar, the sight and manzar, imagine taking out the sword that Mullah Murtaza used to take out. Zulfiqar has come out.